Good morning, everybody. I hope you all are doing well and going through the videos. Today, we are moving forward and continuing exercise 5.2, which we started yesterday. So before moving further, we'll have a quick revision of what we did yesterday in exercise 5.2. So yes, without seeing your notebook, textbook, just in your mind, revise the names of five people we studied yesterday. The topic was weighted aggregative price index number. It had names of six developers, out of which we finished five yesterday. The names were Lasperi's index number, Pastry's price index number, P01 of L, P01 of P. The trick I taught you all was summation P1, leave some space, upon summation P0, leave some space into 100. Where you left the space, write there Q0, Q0 for Lasperi's and Q1, Q1 for Pastry's. After that, do bhaiyo ki jodi I, number 1, Drawbish Bowley, D-B, and Marshall Edgeworth, M-E. Now, Drawbish Bowley, what did they do? They took a simple average. So, Lasperi's plus Pastry's divided by 2. The other part was to write down the formula of Lasperi's plus then write down the formula of Pastry's, put them in round brackets upon 2 into 100. Then after that, we had Marshall Edgeworth. Marshall Edgeworth took the numerator of Lasperi's plus numerator of Pastry's upon denominator of Lasperi's plus denominator of Pastry's. Again, put them in round bracket into 100. Then we studied Fisher's. Fisher's ne kya kiya? Ek bada square root liya. And he substituted Lasperi's and Pastry's and put a multiplication sign in between. This much we had studied yesterday. Now today, as I told you all, we'll be studying about the sixth person, Walsh price index number. Now, why is Walsh price index number so different? The reason being, yesterday, whatever sums we did, in that you used to prepare four different columns. That is P1, Q0, P0, Q0, then P1, Q1, P0, Q1. Walsh price index number also has four columns, but they are slightly different from what we studied yesterday. So as you can see, I have shared the screen in front of you. First, we look at the formula. What does Walsh formula says? So it goes like this. P01 of W is equal to summation. I'll again give you all the same logic. Summation P1 upon summation P0, leave some space over here, into 100. So all the price indexes start with the basic price index ka formula. That is summation P1 upon summation P0. Then you are leaving some space, multiply by 100. Now, jahan pe apne jagah chodi hai, wahan pe what you will write for Walsh, square root of Q0 Q1 upon square root of Q0 Q1. This is the formula for Walsh price index number. Followed, तो वॉल्श ने क्या किया, दोनों क्वांटिटीज को मल्टीप्लाई करके उसका स्क्वायर रूट निकाल लिया. दिस इज व्हाट ही डिड अपार्ट फ्रॉम राइटिंग समेशन P1 एंड समेशन P0. नाउ फॉर द अबव फॉर्मूला यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर फोर कॉलम्स. जैसे आई टोल्ड यू ऑल इन द लास्ट सम वी प्रिपेयर, इन दिस सम व्हाट आर दोस फोर कॉलम्स. नंबर 1, Q0 Q1. सबसे पहले आप ये वाला कॉलम बनाओगे. आफ्टर दैट उसी Q0 Q1 का स्क्वायर रूट निकालोगे. सो रूट ऑफ Q0 Q1. आफ्टर दैट यू विल मल्टीप्लाई दैट स्क्वायर रूट वाला पार्ट विद करंट ईयर प्राइस P1. सो दिस विल बी योर थर्ड कॉलम, P1 रूट ऑफ Q0 Q1. एंड देन द सेम रूट यू विल बी मल्टीप्लाइंग बाय बेस ईयर प्राइस P0 रूट ऑफ Q0 Q1. So, मैं 2 मिनट दे रही हूँ समझने के लिए. व्हाट डिड आई टेल यू जस्ट नाउ? वॉल्श प्राइस इंडेक्स नंबर, ऑब्जर्व द फॉर्मूला केयरफुली. सी व्हाट आर द फोर डिफरेंट कॉलम्स. एक मिनट ले लो समझने के लिए. व्हाट डिड आई टेल यू ऑल? जस्ट पुट इनसाइड योर ब्रेन्स व्हाट यू हर्ड एंड व्हाट यू आर सीइंग ऑन द स्क्रीन राइट नाउ. ओके, सो फॉलो. व्हाट आर द फोर डिफरेंट कॉलम्स? अभी भी नहीं समझा? देन यू कैन वेट फॉर द सम, देन द लॉजिक विल बी क्लियर फॉर यू. ओके, ऑल राइट. सो वील मूव फॉरवर्ड विद द सम्स. आई विल शो यू. वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद सम नंबर 3 and 4. नाउ पे अटेंशन स्टूडेंट्स. इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक बोथ द सम्स नंबर 3 and 4 आर प्रिंटेड रॉन्ग. There are some values which are wrong in that. So if you will solve the textbook questions, you will not get the answer for question number 3 and 4. So I have given you all the right figures in this particular sums, in both of the sums. So I request you all to practice from here itself and make the corrections in the textbooks later on. So remember, question number 3 and 4 are having corrections. Some values are wrong, so both you have to keep in mind. They are printed wrong in your textbook. So I'll not erase these markings. These markings will make you all understand that there was a printing error in both the sums. All right. So your question will look like this. Before that, I'll just show you in the textbook how does it look, so that you'll understand what it is. Okay. Just give me a second. All right. So here we are, exercise 5.2. So as you can see, question number 3 and 4. Yeah. So here is question number 3. Calculate Walsh price index number in problems 3 and 4. This is the question in your textbook. Some numbers are wrong in the quantity column in both of them. So I have solved the sum by putting the right values. So you can refer to the sums over here. Okay. So the first step, the first basic step which I told you all is, to prepare the four columns. Now, what are these four columns? Q0, Q1, root of Q0, Q1, P1 multiply by root of Q0, Q1, and P0 into root of Q0, Q1. So these are the four columns which you have to prepare. After that, after preparing them, what you will do is, first we'll find out what is Q0, Q1. So as you can see, 16 into 9, I got 144. 16 into 4, I got 64. 28 into 7, I got 196. So after getting Q0, Q1, you will find the root of Q0, Q1. So root of 144 is 12. Root of 64 is 8. Root of 196 is 14. So you got the second column. Now the third one. P1 root of Q0, Q1. Now in P1, you'll see the values like 3, 2 and 7. And you will multiply this 3, 2 and 7 with 12, 8 and 14. So pay attention to the columns which I'm multiplying. 3 into 12, which gave me 36. 2 into 8, which gave me 16. 7 into 14, which gave me 98. Followed. Then coming to the fourth column, P0 root of Q0, Q1. So here is P0 ka column, 4, 6, 8. And then you will be multiplying this by root of Q0, Q1. So I'll get 4 into 12, 48. 6 into 8, 48. 8 into 14, 112. Now in the previous sums, we did the totaling of all the four columns. But in Walsh, we are only concerned by the totaling of the last two columns, which have got prices in them. So for Walsh, please don't go to add all the four columns, only the last two columns, which have got base year price and current year prices. Only that column we have to add. So as you can see in the next line, I put the formula P01 of W is equal to summation P1, leave some space, upon summation P0, leave some space into 100. Phir jahan pe apne jagah chhodi hai, wahan pe you write down root of Q0, Q1 upon root of Q0, Q1. So So is the formula part clear? Okay. Coming to the value part, root of P1, summation P1 ka total was 150. Summation of P0 ka sum was 208 multiply by 100. So what I did was 150 into 100, 15,000 upon 208. Again, this I've solved with the help of the log table. Now I'm not making y'all solve. I want y'all to practice. I have gave y'all enough instructions in the first two sessions. The third one as well. This is the fourth session. So I hope you will have to do it by yourself now. I won't be solving any log from here onwards. If you have doubt, ask me separately, but I will not explain it again now. So in short, I'll just explain how this came from. There are 5 digits up. So 5 minus 1, 4 point. Always remove the characteristic first. Then there are 3 digits down. 3 minus 1, 2 point. We are subtracting them. For log, we require only 4 numbers. The logic is 2, 1, 1. So how will you see 15 under 0 in the log table? So you will get 1761. Here there is no mean difference ka column. Same way you will see 20 under 8. You will get 3181. Again, there is no mean difference ka column over here. Then you will subtract 0, 8, 5, 8 and 1. So again, we are going to anti-log table, putting them in round brackets, and you'll put a A sign over here, which represents anti-log. Then you will see 0.85 under 8. Again, there is no mean difference ka column. So you will get 7211. Now the sum is not over yet. The one which you subtracted, you have to add back. 1 plus 1, 2 you will get. So starting from the first number, 7, 2, then you will put a decimal. So your answer is 72.11. Is the sum clear? How to do? It is very easy. You have to just remember the formula, what all columns you have to make, and then the sum is very easy to solve. Okay. So this is sum number 3, which is printed wrong in your textbook. So I've given the values correctly. So please pay attention to that. Now, as you can see, I've written sum number 4, homework. This is for your practice. So don't practice from the textbook. Keep the PDF in front of you while solving and then practice this sum. So we'll just discuss it orally. What will be the 4 columns without seeing? Tell me. Tell yourselves what will be the 4 columns. Number 1, Q0, Q1. Quantities aap multiply karoge. After that, the second column will be square root of Q0, Q1. After that, the third column will be, you will multiply current year price and base year prices with root of Q0, Q1. Charo column ka total karenge aap log? Nahi. Sif last ke 2 column ka, that is which have got prices in them, base year and current year wala. Then you will put Walsh ka formula, and then if the division is easy, you can do it normally, but if it is tough, you can go with log method. So just to tell y'all, I have given the solution also with this, but I expect at least be true to yourself. Mere liye nahi to apne liye pehle khud se solve karna. उसके बाद क्रॉस चेक करने के लिए सोल्यूशन देखना. ईमानदारी से प्रैक्टिस करोगे, आपको फायदा होगा. बोलने का काम मेरा है, बाकी आपकी चॉइस है. ओके, सो थर्ड एंड फोर्थ सम इज ओवर ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 5.2. सो वी हैव फिनिश्ड विद फर्स्ट, सेकंड, थर्ड, फोर्थ. यस्टरडे आई आल्सो एक्सप्लेन्ड यू ऑल फिफ्थ, सिक्स, सेवन, एट सम. सो मूविंग फॉरवर्ड विद द लास्ट 3 सम्स इन द एक्सरसाइज, दैट इज 9th, 10th एंड 11th. So we'll be finishing off with exercise 5.2 today itself. All right. So moving forward with the next 3 sums, coming to sum number 9. Before I show you all the solution, let's have a look at the question first. So here goes the question. Sum number 9. Here, find X in the following table. If Lasperi's and Pastry's price index numbers are equal. So while reading the question, be very careful what you all are reading and understand the question first. They are telling you to find the missing value of X, which is here. And apart from that, what is given? Lasperi's and Pastry's price index number are equal. दैट मीन्स दे आर टेलिंग यू एल जो है वो इक्वल है पी के. सो कैन आई से एल इज इक्वल टू पी इन दिस केस. Lasperis is equal to Pastis, or it is as good as you can say LHS is equal to RHS. So question clear hai? What you're gonna solve? Okay. So sum is very easy. Lasperis or Pastis hai. Before I show you all the solution, kya karte hain hum Lasperis or Pastis mein? How many columns do we prepare? Tell me. Three. One. Four. Okay. Four columns. What are those four columns? Lasperis ka numerator, denominator, Pastis ka numerator and denominator. Okay. Chalo. Kuch to samajh mein aa raha hai aap logo ko. I hope you all will do the sum properly. I'll show you all the solution. Just a second. All right. So as you can see the ninth sum, I have prepared the four columns. P0, Q0, P0, Q1. P1, Q0, P1, Q1. Okay, so these are the four columns which we prepared. So as you can see, 2 tens are 20, 2 fives are 10. So 20 plus 10, 30 dega. P0, Q1, that is 2 fives are 10, 2 twos are 4. 10 plus 4 will give me 14. P1, Q0, 10 twos are 20, 5 into x, 5x. Remember yesterday, we don't add the alphabets and number. So, iska total hoga 20 plus 5x. Then you have P1, Q1. 2 5s are 10. X into 2, 2x. So, 10 plus 2x. Followed with the four columns and they are totaling. Okay. Coming to the next heading. What did I write here? Abhi yaad hai kuch maine red pen se likha tha piche. Question mein diya hai L is equal to P. That means, can I say P01 of L is equal to P01 of P? Okay. So that means left hand side mein kiska formula aega? Lasperis ka formula. Right hand side mein kiska formula aega? Pastis ka formula. So Lasperis formula, what was the trick? Summation P1, leave some space. Upon summation P0, leave some space into 100. Q0, Q0. सेम लॉजिक पैस्टीज के साथ आप करेंगे लेकिन उसके बदले व्हाट विल यू राइट Q1 Q1. सो इज द दिस पार्ट पर्टिकुलर पार्ट क्लियर. नाउ इफ यू ऑल सी व्हाट डिड आई डू लास्ट ईयर व्हेन आई वाज टीचिंग यू ऑल मैथमेटिक्स आई टोल्ड यू ऑल इक्वल टू के इस पार एंड इक्वल टू के उस पार अगर रहता है तो यू कैन कैंसिल द नंबर्स और एनी वेज क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई करोगे तो 100 नीचे आ जाएगा सो 100 विल गेट कैंसिल. ओके तो खाली समेशन वाले पार्ट बचते 1, 2, 3, 4. सो वी विल राइट द समेशन एंड कहां से आई ये चारों समेशन इट केम फ्रॉम द टेबल व्हिच वी कैलकुलेटेड अबव. सो इसका टोटल वाज 20 प्लस 5x अपॉन 30 इज इक्वल टू 10 प्लस 2x अपॉन 14. सो इफ यू ऑल रिमेंबर व्हाट डिड आई टेल यू ऑल व्हेनेवर यू सी अ वेरिएबल ऐसा x वाला दिखता है अगर always put a habit of putting them in round brackets like this. Okay, when you all put them in round brackets, they will always tell you ki apne ko kata piti nahi karni hai. That is, don't cancel 20 and 30 ka zero or don't go for canceling 10 and 14 and 2. Now in the next step, what did I do is bringing the like terms together. That is, as you see, 20 plus 5x upon 10 plus 2x. So I just did a cross multiply over here like this. 30 went up upon 14. So is this two steps clear? Okay. Then again put them in bracket. 20 plus 5x upon 10 plus 2x. I reduce 30 and 14. So it gives me 15 upon 7. Now again what will you do? You will do a cross multiply over here. So 7 into 20 plus 5x and 15 into 10 plus 2x. The reason of telling you all to put this in a bracket is last year I have taught you all jab banda bracket ke bahar rehta hai, it is multiplied by both of them. That means 7 into 20, 140, 7 into 5, 35x. Samajh mein aaya? Keep this logic in mind. That is why I told you to put round brackets here. Okay. The same thing we'll continue 15 into 10 and 15 into 2x. So 15 tens are 150. 15 twos are 30x. Followed? So it gives you 140 plus 35x is equal to 150 plus 30x. Next logic क्या करेंगे आप वापस similar like term साथ में ले आएंगे तो 35 minus 30 will give you 5x, 150 minus 40 will give you 10. So x is equal to 2. So with this first sum gets over. मतलब sum number 9 यहाँ पे खत्म होता है. Is the sum clear? समझ में आ गया अच्छे से? पक्का? बड़े आगे? Okay. Coming to sum number 10. Before that, let me erase this. So coming to sum number 10. Before that, we'll read the question and understand what they are trying to tell us. So here is sum number 10. If Lasbury's price index number is 4 times Pasci's price index number, then find the relationship between Drobish-Bowley and Fisher's price index number. What are the punch words over here? मैंने underline किया आप लोग के लिए. Lasbury's का price index number is 4 times Pasci's price index number. मतलब जैसे ऊपर बोला था L was equal to P. यहाँ पे बोला है L is 4 times of P. 4 times means 4P. तो L is equal to 4P. ऐसा बोला गया है. So they are trying to tell us is what L is equal to 4 times of Pasci's. तो आपको बताना है what is the relationship between Drobish-Bowley and Fisher's. You have to find what kind of relationship exists between Drobish-Bowley and Fisher's. Is the question clear? What they are trying to tell? Okay. Now we'll see the solution, what they are telling us. Just give me a second. So here is the solution. So how did we start? P01 of L is equal to 4 times of P01 of P. That was given in the question. We have to find the relation between Drobish-Bowley and Fisher's. That is P01 D dash B and P01 of F. So how will we go about it? सबसे पहले start करते हैं Drobish-Bowley से. तो Drobish-Bowley का formula क्या बोलता है? Drobish-Bowley's price index number states that Lasbury's plus Pasci's upon 2. Average निकाला था ना उसने. Now just now I explained you all Lasbury's का value क्या है? 4 गुना Pasci's. मतलब P01 of L का value क्या था? 4 times of P01 of P. बराबर है? ऊपर हमने देखा था, question में दिया है. So we substituted the value of Lasbury's in like 4P01 of P. Now this is 4P01 of P. यहाँ पे 1P01 of P है. 1 है नहीं, but exist करता है ना? इतना तो पता है आप लोगों को. So 4 plus 1, क्या आएगा answer मेरा? 5P01 of P. Point number 1. ये हो गया आपका पहला value. This is your point number 1. अभी Drobish-Bowley के बाद हम next किसको उठाएंगे? Fisher's को उठाएंगे. So next line you will write P01 of F root of Lasbury's multiply by Pasci's. Again I told you Lasbury's का substitution करेंगे हम. So in place of Lasbury's we wrote 4 times of P01 of P multiply by P01 of P. Now 4 will remain there only. What is P01 of P into P01 of P? P01 of P the whole square. Okay. Last year I had explained you all whenever there is a root and square, wo cancel ho jata hai. Okay. Just give me a second. It gets cancelled. Okay. The same way what will we do is we will cancel square and root. समझा? Square और root cancel हो जाएगा. So what will remain? P01 of P and at the same time 4 का square root क्या होता है? 2 होता है. तो अपना answer क्या आ गया? 2P01 of P point number 2. आ गया समझ में? First step and second step. तो originally what did we do? Drobish-Bowley का formula डाला and Fisher's का formula डाला and we removed point number 1 and 2. अभी हम 1 और 2 से क्या करने वाले हैं? Pay attention. Can you all see point number 1? Can you all see point number 2? Now what is common in 1 and 2? Can anybody observe and tell me 1 and 2 mein kya common hai? Observe karke bolo, niche answer dekke mat bolna, apna dimag lagao. दोनों में दिख रहा है P01 of P, P01 of P common है. तो what I will do is, I will keep P01 of P उधर ही and बाकी सबको cross multiply करके shift कर दूंगी. तो what did I do is, 2 को उधर भेज दिया, 5 को नीचे भेज दिया. तो समझा ये वाला step कैसे आया. Point number 3, P01 of P is equal to 2 times of Drawbish Bowley upon 5. सेम वे फिशर्स के साथ कर देंगे, ये 2 को अपन क्रॉस करके डिनोमिनेटर में भेज देंगे. सो P01 ऑफ P का वैल्यू क्या हो जाएगा, P01 ऑफ F डिवाइडेड बाय 2. दिस इज माय पॉइंट नंबर 4. अंडरस्टूड, गिविंग यू ऑल 2 मिनट्स टू ऑब्जर्व क्या हुआ. आई नो इट्स टू मच बट इट्स वेरी सिंपल. स्टेप नंबर 1 Drawbish Bowley का फॉर्मूला, स्टेप नंबर 2 फिशर्स का फॉर्मूला, यू गॉट 1 एंड 2. Now, दोनों में पैस्ट्रीज कॉमन है, कम क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई करके दोनों में पैस्ट्रीज का फॉर्मूला निकालेंगे. यहां तक किया हम लोग, ओके, ऑल राइट. सो दैट बिकेम माय पॉइंट नंबर 3 and 4. ओके, देखते हैं अभी नेक्स्ट स्टेप क्या हुआ नीचे. सो फ्रॉम 3 and 4, नाउ व्हाट विल बी योर कंक्लूजन. सो फ्रॉम 3 and 4 नथिंग, दोनों में कॉमन क्या है, पैस्ट्रीज कॉमन है. तो क्या मैं बोल सकती हूँ 3 इज इक्वल टू 4, बिकॉज दोनों भी पैस्ट्रीज के वैल्यू है. सो अगर दोनों पैस्ट्रीज के वैल्यू है, सो फ्रॉम 3 and 4 LHS इज इक्वल टू RHS. दैट मींस 2 टाइम्स ऑफ Drawbish Bowley अपॉन 5 इज इक्वल टू फिशर्स अपॉन 2. फिर नेक्स्ट स्टेप अपन ने क्या किया, कुछ नहीं, खाली क्रॉस मल्टीप्लाई किया. तो मैंने Drawbish Bowley को इधर छोड़ दिया, 5 ऊपर चला गया, 2 नीचे आ गया. So 5, when it went up, 5 into P01 of F upon 2 2s became 4. This is the required relationship. So what did we prove? That Drawbish Bowley is equal to 5 upon 4 times of Fishers. This is the required relationship. Samja, some little bit is here and there. Thoda atrangi sa sam hai, but it is easy one. If you pay attention, you will understand the entire concept, what I explained you all just now. All right? Okay. So finally, coming towards the last sum for the day of this particular exercise. So we'll just have a look at the question, sum number 11. If Drawbish Bowley and Fisher's price index numbers are 5 and 4, then find Lasperi's and Pastries. Now, in sum number 10th, you found out the relationship between Drawbish Bowley and Fishers. Now, they are telling you, agar Drawbish Bowley ka value is 5 and Fishers ka price index number is 4, then you have to find out Lasperi's and Pastries price index numbers from the following. Okay? So, we'll just have a look over here how we solved the sum. So, can everybody see the solution page? Okay. Drawbish Bowley's price index number is 5. Fisher's price index number is 4. Given. Now, Drawbish Bowley price index number ka formula is Lasperi's plus Pastries divided by 2. So, Drawbish Bowley ka value is given 5 here, as you all can see. Lasperi's and Pastries we don't know, the whole upon 2. So, 2 will go that side. 2 5s are 10. 10 is equal to Lasperi's plus Pastries. Point number 1. This much part clear? Kuch nahi kiya, khali formula dala hai abhi tak. Alright, so is this step clear up till here? Point number 1, great. Now coming to Fisher's. Fisher's price index number ka formula was Lasperi's multiply by Pastries together. So again, we don't know what is Lasperi's and Pastries, but yes, we know what is Fisher's ka value. It is 4, so I put here 4. Alright, now what happened after this? After putting 4? Now I'm squaring both the sides because I have to remove the square root sign. मुझे वहाँ से square root sign को हटाना है. So what I'll do is squaring both the sides. So squaring both the sides, we get 4 the whole square is equal to root of P01 of L into P01 of P the whole square. Now just now I explained you all root and square gets cancelled. So as you can see, I have cancelled square and root over here. Okay. Now what is 4 ka square? 4 4s are 16. So 16 is equal to square or root hat gaya tha. Lasperi's multiply by Pastries. Point number 2. Okay. This is my second step. Now for simplicity, in यू नो टू मेक द सम सिंपल, अभी तक हमको क्या मिला, लैस्परीज प्लस पैस्चीज इज इक्वल टू 10 एंड लैस्परीज इनटू पैस्चीज इज इक्वल टू 16. दैट इज माय पॉइंट नंबर 3 एंड पॉइंट नंबर 4. ओके, नाउ व्हाट विल आई डू इज लैस्परीज को मैंने यहाँ पे रखा एंड आई सेंड दिस पी दैट साइड. तो प्लस किस में कन्वर्ट हो गया, माइनस में कन्वर्ट हो गया. सो इन दिस पर्टिकुलर स्टेप व्हाट डिड आई डू, लैस्परीज एल को इधर ही रखा है एंड आई हैव ट्रांसफर्ड पी दैट साइड. सो दिस बिकेम 10 माइनस पी, पॉइंट नंबर 5. ओके, नाउ व्हाट विल आई डू इज आई विल सब्स्टिट्यूट दिस वैल्यू ऑफ एल इन पॉइंट नंबर 4. सो आई विल सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ एल इन पॉइंट नंबर 4 यहाँ पे. So as you can see, in place of L, I've written 10 minus P into P is equal to 16. So P dono se multiply hoga. 10 into P, 10P minus P square is equal to 16. So we'll now arrange it systematically in the form of a quadratic equation. So I'll transfer P square over here. It will become plus P square. 10P wahan pe jayega, so it will become minus 10P. Plus 16 is there only, is equal to 0. So you got a quadratic equation. Now to solve this quadratic equation, there are two steps. Number one, splitting the middle term. Jaise aap normal quadratic equation solve karte hain. Ya nahi to, last year in complex numbers, you studied the format na, solve the following quadratic equation. 10th standard ka method tha. Minus b plus minus root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a. So you can use that method also. I have shown you all both the methods. Dono bhi method aap log kar sakte ho. Dono mein se koi bhi method you can do. That is correct. I have done by quadratic equation because that is a simpler method. Or you can solve it by this method also. Quadratic equation by complex numbers. So the factors are minus 8 and minus 2. Minus 8 minus 2 will give me plus 16. Minus 8 minus 2 will give me minus 10. So p square minus 8p minus 2p plus 16 is equal to 0. So I'll make a pair like this by underlining. P I'll remove common, p minus 8 minus 2, p minus 8 is equal to 0. So p minus 8 into p minus 2 is equal to 0. P is equal to 8 or p is equal to 2. So that is पैस्चीज का आंसर वी गॉट, बट वी गॉट टू आंसर्स. तो डेफिनेटली लैस्परीज भी दो आंसर होंगे. सो यू विल सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यूज इन पॉइंट नंबर 5 और यू हैव 6 इक्वेशंस. यू हैव 5 इक्वेशंस, आप किसी में भी डाल सकते हो, इन प्लस माइनस मल्टीप्लाई वेर एवर यू विश टू. आई हैव सब्स्टिट्यूटेड इन पॉइंट नंबर 5. एल इज इक्वल टू 10 माइनस पी. सो एल इज इक्वल टू 10 माइनस पी. पहला वैल्यू पी का आई एम डूइंग द पार्टीशन हियर. Because I've got two values of pastries. When p is equal to 8, when p is equal to 2. So l is equal to 10 minus p. 10 minus 8, answer is 2. Or l is equal to 10 minus 2, l is equal to 8. So with this, we got Lasperies and pastries both values. So it is like this. When Lasperies is 2, pastries is 8. And when pastries is 2, Lasperies is 8. So this is the way we have solved the sums and finishing with exercise 5.2, which included 6 developers, Walsh, Lasperies, Pastries, Drawbridge Bowley, Marshall Edgeworth and Fishers. Now in order for your practice, I have given some assignment sums as you can see. Calculate Walsh price index number. Here is the question. Find X if Lasperies price index number is the same as Pastries price index number. The third one, find X if price index number using simple aggregative method is 200. Mix and match hai dono exercises ke sum. Let me see without seeing, without copying, aap ye practice kar paate ho ya nahi. Jo log practice karenge, answer main next session mein declare karne wali hu. But I will not disclose the answer in PDF format nor in writing. I will be telling the answers orally. Yesterday I told you all, I'll be telling you all the answers of the logarithm table which I had given you all. So I'll be a little slower while dictating. The people can listen to it and check their answers. Now, for sum number 5, 6 and 7 of exercise 5.1. I gave you all sum number 5, 6 and 7 to practice. The answer of the sum number 5 of logarithm is 127.8. I repeat, 127.8. Answer to sum number 6 is 131.2. I repeat, 131.2. Answer to sum number 7 is 141.8. I repeat, 141.8. So these three sums I had given to solve. Apart from that, when I was teaching your law, I also gave you all in the second part three sums to practice logarithm. The first question was 238,900 divided by 343. The answer to this is 696.6. I repeat, 696.6. Second question was 238 upon 141. The answer is 1.689. I repeat, 1.689. And the last one, 10475 divided by 2343. This was the question. The answer is 4.576. I repeat, 4.576. So these are the answers to the questions which I gave you all for practice. Now today also I gave you all sum number 4, Walshka. I have given you all the solution. जो लोग ईमानदार हैं, सच्चे हैं, वो लोग पहले खुद से ट्राई करेंगे, फिर सॉल्यूशन रेफर करोगे. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट, दीज थ्री सम्स आई हैव गिवन फॉर असाइनमेंट. इफ यू ऑल प्रैक्टिस, इट्स गुड फॉर यू ऑल. इफ यू ऑल डू नॉट प्रैक्टिस, दैट्स अप टू यू. आई वोंट फोर्स यू. सो विद दिस वी स्टॉप टुडेज सेशन. थैंक यू स्टूडेंट्स फॉर लिसनिंग टू मी.